Hello students, welcome back to my class Words of Wisdom. So now we are going to study the fourth part of subject verb concord or subject verb agreement, plural form singular meaning, plural form plural meaning. Till now we have studied that subject verb concord has six basic parts under which the study of subject verb concord is completed. So we studied about general rules, then compound subjects, group nouns, then now we are going to continue plural form singular meaning, plural form or plural meaning. So an agreement of a verb in a sentence according to its person and number is called subject verb concord or subject verb agreement. So if your subject is in singular number, you will use singular verb, but if your subject is in plural number, you will place plural verb. Now the problem comes, there are some words the spelling of which end with the letter S. Okay, normally a noun ending with the letter S usually forms plural meaning, like box, boxes, car, cars. But there are some nouns that end with the letter S but don't form a plural meaning always. Which are those words? They are often name of subjects. They are often names of games, tennis, chess. Then sometimes name of title and books as well. Okay. And finally, there are some nouns ending with S that form a singular and a plural meaning both. So there are some nouns that end with S, they take singular meaning also and plural meaning also. Okay, so that is why plural form is a part of group noun. That is why plural form is a part of group noun. But group noun, so we can say, but not all the words are included in group noun, because there we have studied that the formation of some words are like that, they seem like they are plural in form but they are not actually plural. Okay, so we can't count those words in group nouns. So now we are going to learn step by step how to place verbs according to these subjects. Plural form singular meaning. Rule 1. Plural form singular meaning. So as just we discussed that some nouns the spelling of which end with letter S seem like plural in form but they are not actually plural. Billiards, chess, measles and mumps, this is the name of disease. These two words are included in disease. Then physics, mathematics, subject name, billiards, chess, name of games, Arabian Nights, name of book. So when you are having formation of the noun like this, they will only take singular verb. The news is fake. Physics is an easy subject. Tennis plays an important role in my life. Then, plural form, plural meaning. But sometimes nouns, especially ending with I-C-S, take plural verbs also. Okay, so when these subjects are spoken as whole field or subject, okay, whole field or subject, they always take singular verb. They always take singular verb. But when the same subjects, same words are talked as if having different data, beliefs or principles, okay, so in such conditions, such words are converted in plural form. Okay, they change in plural form. That is why we will place plural. Wow. Okay. Politics is a dirty game. So here, politics has been talked as if a feat, while here politics in friendship spoil the relationship. That means different beliefs. Here politics is connected with the different beliefs, okay, or different behavior. Statics is my favorite subject. Statics show that we are using 5v5. Girls are often interested in arts while boys in science subject. Then plural form, plural meaning. There are some nouns, the part of whose are two, they are parted in two parts, and the spelling of which also end with s, with the letter s. So such kinds of words always take plural form because they are having two parts, so they are assumed as plural meaning. So that is why they will take only plural verb. My scissors are dull. Scissors are having two parts. Okay. Now did you get? I just made mistake. Scissors is. We will not use scissor is. Scissors is. We will use scissors are. Because a scissor have two parts. Okay. So that is why. Your tongues are strong enough to hold the bread perfectly. Tongues like chimta. ओके तो जो चिमटा होता है उसके भी दो पार्ट्स होते हैं, इसी वजह से उसे भी प्लूरल फॉर्म भी लिया गया, इसीलिए प्लूरल वर्ब को प्लेस किया गया उसके साथ. नाउ हियर कम्स वन एक्सेप्शन, प्लूरल फॉर्म कलेक्टिव नाउन. नाउ व्हेन द सेम प्लूरल फॉर्म्स टेक द फॉर्म ऑफ कलेक्टिव नाउन इन सच कंडीशन, अ पेयर ऑफ सीजर्स, अ बैंड ऑफ म्यूजिशियंस, अ पेयर ऑफ ट्राउजर्स, व्हेन यू टेक ऑल दीस nouns in collective forms, they always take singular verb. Okay, means when the same words are used independently we will use plural verb, but when the same words are taking form of collective nouns, in such conditions we will use only singular verb. A pair of scissors has been sharpened by me. A pack of wolves has attacked the villagers. Abstract noun, plural form, plural meaning, plural verb. Now see, as we know that the abstract nouns, we always place singular verb. Happiness is a key to success. Okay. So happiness with abstract noun we always use. In normal cases with abstract noun we use singular verb, but here we can notice that arms and riches, these are two rich. The word riches has been made up with the word rich, that is adjective or abstract noun. So they have been changed into plural forms, and because they have been changed into plural form, they will take only plural meaning. Okay, and that is why only the plural verb will be used here. Riches have wings. Arms were given to the beggars. So riches, what is the meaning of riches? Dhan. Lakshmi. Riches have wings, यानी लक्ष्मी चंचल होती है. ठीक है. Arms were given to beggars. तो इन दो वर्ड्स के साथ हमेशा plural verb place होगा. Then adjectives, collective nouns, plural nouns, plural verb. Now again adjectives, with adjectives we always place singular noun. Now if the same adjectives take the form of collective noun. Collective noun means, like for example, when you are writing the rich, that means द वर्ड और फ्रेज हैज टेकन फॉर्म ऑफ कलेक्टिव नाउन, यानी कि द रिच मीन्स अमीर लोग, ठीक है, क्या हो गया, अमीर लोग, यानी कि लोगों की बात हो गई, ठीक है। इसी वजह से हम हमेशा इसमें प्लूरल, क्योंकि इसने प्लूरल कलेक्टिव नाउन का फॉर्म लिया तो ये प्लूरल नाउन हो गया, और इसी वजह से हम इसके साथ हमेशा प्लूरल वर्ब का यूज करते हैं, ठीक है। तो द रिच हैव डोनेटेड अ लॉट, द रिच हैव, ओके। बी अटेंटिव, यू कैन इजीली रिकॉग्नाइज इट इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी एडजेक्टिव एंड बिफोर दैट एडजेक्टिव इफ यू फाइंड द वर्ड द, इफ यू फाइंड द वर्ड द, ओके। सो instantly catch it that it is a noun and that is collective noun, okay। और collective noun यानी कि एक living being बन गया है अब वो, ठीक है, और इसी वजह से, और living being में भी ये एक collective form इसने ले ली है, तो इसी वजह से हम इसके साथ हमेशा plural form का, plural verb का use करेंगे। The blind are taught with braille. Then plural form, singular meaning. Miles, dozens, scores, square, wheel, cross. See, these are the words that are actually measurements or units. So, इनके साथ अगर number आते हैं, है ना? If all these measurements are connected with the numbers, in such cases we always use singular verb. 100 rupee was spent, thousands bird was flying in the sky. 5 miles is not a long distance. ठीक है, इसमें हमें एक बात ध्यान रखनी है कि अगर noun आता है जैसे 10,000, ठीक है, काउंटिंग के बाद, नंबर के बाद तुरंत मेजरमेंट आता है, और मेजरमेंट के बाद अगर मेजरमेंट या यूनिट जो भी नापने की जो भी यूनिट होती है वो जो भी आती है, और उसके साथ अगर नाउन आता है कोई भी, तो उसमें हमें ये ध्यान रखना है कि उसका प्लूरल फॉर्म हमें नहीं लिखना है। लाइक 10 dozens मैंगोस नहीं होगा, 10 dozen मैंगो होगा, ठीक है। तो इसी वजह से ये क्योंकि पूरा का पूरा जो फोकस है ये एक यूनिट के रूप में काम कर रहा है, ठीक है, ये जो हमारा पूरा का पूरा फ्रेज है यूनिट के रूप में काम कर रहा है, तो इसी वजह से हम इसका यूज करते हैं, ओनली सिंगुलर फॉर्म का, सिंगुलर वर्ब का यूज करते हैं ऐसी कंडीशन में। इसके बाद इसी तरह से मेजरमेंट में, यही से मेजरमेंट अगर वर्ड ऑफ से कनेक्टेड होते हैं तो ऐसी कंडीशन में हम प्लूरल फॉर्म का यूज करते हैं, ओके। If all these measurements are connected with of, and after that you are having nouns, and in such condition there is one more important thing to keep in mind, that here after the units we are using s, the word s, and in nouns also we are using s or es. Both the at both the places we will place their plural form, and that is why only we will use plural verb. Okay students, now we are going to do exercises. The news dash brought a great happiness for me. So obviously we have studied that news is a part of singular noun. So news, and we are having third form also. That means it is a perfect tense. The news has brought a great happiness for me. Hard Times Dash, written by Charles Dickens. What has been, have been, or what? Now, Hard Times is the name of the book. It is the name of the book that is written by Charles Dickens. Oh. Hard Time was written by Charles Dickens. So, sorry, here we are having two right options. Hard Times has been written by Charles Dickens, or Hard Times was written by Charles Dickens. A set of combs dash purchased by me yesterday. Was purchased, has been purchased, will be purchased, or have been purchased. So a set of forms again, plural form has taken the form of group noun. So that is why we will place here singular verb. A set of form was purchased by me yesterday. The truthful dash suffer a lot in life. The truthful dash suffer a lot in their life. So the truthful, that means adjective, has taken the form of collective noun. Yani satyavadi ho, sachche ho. So the truthful have to suffer a lot in their life. My spectacles dash being lost somewhere. Spectacles again, a noun that is having two parts. So we will place plural verb have been. My spectacles have been lost somewhere. Fourth fifths of his happiness dash due to his positive thinking. Students, here comes a thing that when your focus is on the number and the word is connected with of, but after that you are not having any measurement. Simply fourth, fifth. Okay. So in such conditions, we will place only plural verb. Fourth, fifth of his happiness are due to his positive thinking. A team of speaker dash selected. A team of speakers, because it is a team group noun, has been selected. So this part has been completed. Okay. In the next part, I am going to explain you the rules of indefinite pronoun. Till then, keep on making the mission. Thank you. Be learning.